so fortunate to have some unbelievably good theater companies here in St. Louis, and one of the best, and one of my favorite, is the Black Rep. And a new play, Anne and Emmett, is opening at the Black Rep tomorrow. We're joined by some really neat people here to talk all about it. We have playwright Janet Langhart Cohen, and to her right is her husband, former U.S. Secretary of Defense William Cohen, a member of the board at CBS.
Is that why he's on the show?
Yes, under the Clinton administration. Not the CBS one, but the White House one. And you're who?
Ron Himes.
Don who?
Ron Himes.
Ron Himes, yes. From the Black Rep. We're glad you're here, Ron. Yeah. Ron's representing the, you know, one of the worst golfers. I think you play that bet on purpose, don't you?
Yes, I do. To make you look good.
It worked. Ron's one of my favorite people. And you are now, because I think this is just a remarkable concept for a play. We all remember the Anne Frank story. Mm-hmm. We remember the Emmett Till story. To take two people who have gone through this similar intolerance experience from different sides of the world and bring them together. That's what this play is about, right?
Exactly. These two lovely, iconic martyrs have haunted me my whole life. I first learned of Anne Frank when I was 15 years old, and her diary was required reading at my all-black high school. Mm-hmm. And she was 15 at the time, 14 and 15 at the time, right. She was writing the diary, so I could identify with her. And coming from a group, African-American, who feared the larger society, I could identify with her and her family hiding in the attic, the annex from the Nazis. Mm-hmm. And of course, Emmett Till is or was the same age as I, born in the same region, of the same culture. And I remember that day as though it was yesterday when we learned that Emmett Till had been murdered, and that picture of him in Jet magazine. So bringing these two young people who are from disparate backgrounds but have the commonality of being murdered, who lived in societies that couldn't protect them.
Such different societies, though. That's the intriguing thing to me. I mean, to bring two Southern African Americans together, I could understand, or to bring two Jewish people that have gone through the Holocaust would make sense. But this is really compelling, I think.
Oh, thank you.
And I wonder where the inspiration comes from.
I had just released my book, From Rage to Reason, My Life into America. Mm-hmm. It's a memoir. And a friend of mine in Washington said to me at a lunch, Janet, what two Americas are you talking about? And I said, the two Americas that I've lived in. I grew up in an apartheid America and a segregated Jim Crow America. I was born in 1941. And now I live in the America of promise, to be married to the former Secretary of Defense, and he led the finest military in the world. So I've seen two. And my friend said to me, well, Janet, why do you want to go back and talk about segregation and Jim Crow? It would be so unbecoming of you to be a victim. And I didn't feel like a victim. And I thought, I wonder why she'd say that. And I came home and I told Bill, I said, my friend thought it's unbecoming of me to talk about my history. There are histories and people who have struggles who say, remember, never forget. Mm-hmm. But we African Americans are told to forget, get over it, it's history. So I thought, what would Anne Frank have said to Emmett Till? I bet she would have understood. I bet she would have been more sensitive.
Sometimes we have to take a step back in order to move forward sometimes, I think. Isn't that true?
True.
Mr. Cohen, you're producing this thing, correct?
Yes.
I have been. I'm
turning
that
over
now.
That's a little different role.
I'm turning over to Ron now that he's the producer of this particular production.
And the director.
So he's done an outstanding job and has taken the concept and is going to introduce some new levels of intrigue. So we're looking forward to it.
I can understand why they used to call her the First Lady of the Pentagon, huh?
Well, there are two words that are very important in our marriage. Yes, dear.
You learned them quickly.
But you know, I'm excited. This is my first play, and to have Ron Himes and the Black Rep here in St. Louis debut it tonight. We're debuting tonight, and I think it's running.
What did I tell you about him when you came in? I said he's a local treasure.
He is. He's now a national treasure because I know he's going to be doing more things with Anne and Emmett around the country.
A challenging play to produce.
Yeah, it has been, but you know, a task of joy, and it's been very illuminating to work with with a company that has embodied these characters, sure, and bring them to life in a way that is really going to touch people now through November the 4th.
Well, thank you all so much for being here.
Thank
We're
you,
just
Ken.
Thrilled to have
thank
you here. Anne and Emmett is playing October 26th through November 4th at the Grandel Theater. Beautiful, beautiful old theater. For more information or to buy tickets, please call the Black Rep at 314-534-3810 and find out about all the other productions that are coming out of the Black Rep this season. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
Pleasure
thank you again. I wanted more.
I want to know. I want to see the show.